What if someone rejected to marry with a right person? What if someone accepted to marry with a wrong person? In both cases, rejecting to marry with a right person or accepting to marry with a wrong person, the decision would be a wrong decision. And why a decision happens to be a wrong decision? It happens because of errors in decision making. Of course, I am not discussing the marriage issues here, like with whom one should marry and with whom one shouldn't marry. In fact, here I am discussing the issues related with decision making. But to marry with someone is also an important decision of life for all of us, isn't it? Hello everyone, welcome to Shake Hand with Life, a YouTube channel. I am Narendra Sharma. At every point of time in our daily life, we have to take decisions, like to accept what is good for us and to reject what is not good for us, isn't it? And many times it happens to us, we make the error when we take a decision. And as a result of that error, sometimes we have to pay a lot. So in this video, we will study the two types of error, type 1 and type 2 error, related to decision making concerning to hypothesis testing. Now for testing a hypothesis, there is a chance that one could reject a null hypothesis when it is true, or at the same time there is a chance that one could accept null hypothesis when it is not true. In both cases, there is a possibility of committing an error to make a decision. Hence, there is a decision rule to accept or reject a null hypothesis. That means how one can make a decision to accept or reject a null hypothesis. So concerning to the decision making, we have two conditions. Either the null hypothesis H0 is true or the null hypothesis H0 is not true. So to make a decision, either we accept the null hypothesis or reject the null hypothesis. Now, if we accept the null hypothesis because the null hypothesis is true, that implies we are taking correct decision. And if we reject the null hypothesis even though the null hypothesis is true, that implies we are taking wrong decision. That means we are making type 1 error or alpha error. Now for second condition, when the null hypothesis is not true. In that case, if we accept the null hypothesis even though the null is not true, that means taking a wrong decision and making type 2 error or beta error. And when the null is rejected because the null is not true, that means we are taking correct decision. Now let's understand with a simple example. Taking a decision of marriage. Everybody wants to marry with a right person, right? So here to marry with a right person is null hypothesis H0, and to marry with a wrong person is alternative hypothesis HA. Now let's discuss the first condition. To marry with a right person is null hypothesis. This one is the first condition. If someone accepted to marry with a right person, then he or she will lead a happy married life and this will be a correct decision. But if someone rejected to marry with a right person, then he or she is making type 1 error or alpha error, which means loss of love and companionship with right person, isn't it? Now come to the second condition, to marry with a wrong person, which is alternative hypothesis. So if you accepted to marry with a wrong person, then either you will lead an unhappy married life or going for divorce, or you may lose the faith in marriage, isn't it? And if you rejected to marry with a wrong person, then this will be absolutely correct decision, because you are avoiding all the consequences that could have ruined your personal life. Now let's take another example of rejecting or accepting a production lot by a quality checker in manufacturing industry. Suppose a lot has the defective items less than acceptance quality level, AQL, is considered as okay. And if the lot has the defective items more than acceptance quality level, then it is considered as not okay. Here the lot with defective items less than acceptance quality level is null hypothesis, and the lot with defective items more than AQL is alternate hypothesis. Now a quality checker has to make a decision to accept the lot or reject the lot. So here the two conditions are defectives less than acceptance quality level and the defectives more than acceptance quality level. Now come to the first condition. If the lot with defective less than acceptance quality level or AQL accepted by the quality checker, then the decision is correct. It means the lot is okay and it will be sent to warehouse for dispatch. On the contrary, if the lot is rejected and sent to quarantine, even though it has defective items less than AQL, then the decision taken is wrong and quality checker made type 1 error or alpha error. Here the alpha error will contribute to reshorting and repacking cost, waste of manpower, waste of time, etc., etc. Even when the lot is okay or acceptable. Now come to the second condition. Here the lot with defectives more than acceptance quality level accepted by the quality checker and release the lot to warehouse for dispatch. In this case, quality checker committed the type 2 error or beta error. And as a result of this error, the quality checker created the opportunity of customer complaint, which could lead to financial loss, goodwill loss, and also the loss of business from the customer. But if the quality checker rejected the lot and sent it to quarantine, then it will be a correct decision. That's all in this video. If you have any doubt, then do write your feedback in comment box below. Hit the like button if you like this video and share it among your friends and colleagues. Click here to visit on shakehandwithlife.in to download the course notes and ebooks in PDF. Click here to subscribe Shake Hand with Life YouTube channel and press the bell to receive notifications of my latest videos. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon in my next video with a new topic. Till then, bye-bye.